So far we saw about what is controlled vocabulary and what is the need for controlled vocabulary with specific examples, right? So moving on from that, today we are going to discuss about various subject headings. And first one we are going to discuss is Library of Congress subject heading. So we will see what LCSH is and what's its principles and other various aspects of LCSH. So before getting into Library of Congress subject headings, you must understand what is subject heading actually. So you know what is a subject, right? And you know what is a heading. So combine these two phrases, a word or phrases selected from a standard list of subjects. Okay, there are standard list of subjects, let's say physics or chemistry or whatever it may be. A word or phrases from a list of subjects. In physics, we call it as quantum mechanics or motion, force, velocity. These are what you call headings from selected from the subject. Okay, to express the main subject of a book in the library catalog or electronic bibliographical databases. Okay, so it is to express the thought content of the book. Let it be in a catalog, in a physical catalog, or in a electronic bibliographical database. Bibliographical database in the sense, you must remember Web of Science or Scopus or Google Scholar. Okay. So we call it as, it is also called as subject descriptor, and it is also called as keywords. When you are using a database, it's called as keywords. When you are referring to specific headings or index, it's called as subject headings, and depending upon the context, the name varies, or subject descriptor. So in keywords, in database, we term it as keywords. So what is a subject heading list? You know now what is a subject heading. The list is a controlled vocabulary or standard print of list of synonym terms. Okay, you know what is a controlled vocabulary, right? It is giving a tagging. It is like giving a tag to a particular index or an item, right? Similarly, it is a list of headings or list of items or standard list of synonym terms. That means terms which have similar meanings. Okay, that is synonymous term. So when you see this with an example, you will definitely understand. So subject heading is nothing but an heading used to represent the thought content of the subject. It is also called as keywords in terms of database, subject descriptors. Okay. So these are the different kinds of subject heading lists actually. So Library of Congress subjects, it covers all subject areas. Whereas CR list covers only social science, and MeSH medical subject covers only medical sciences, and UNESCO Thesaurus social science AgroWorks subject heading list covers agriculture. So these are the commonly used subject heading list. So today in this lesson, we are going to discuss only Library of Congress subject headings. Okay. So this is the year of establishments. Please make a note of this, as they might ask these in NET exams also. It is very much important. Please make a note of this year of establishment. Okay, so those are the various subject heading lists. So now we are going to see what is a local authority. So local authority list of subject headings, that is called a subject authority file. They call it as a subject authority file. That is nothing but a list of subject headings. Whatever heading they are listing out, they are calling it as a subject authority file. So this heading list instructs a cataloger how to assign subject heading while cataloging and indexing the resources. Okay, so this particular list of headings giving instruction to the cataloger in order how to assign a subject heading while doing the cataloging and indexing procedure. Okay, so it provides instruction. This list provides instruction to the cataloger or indexer. Okay, in order to assign indexing terms or even assign subject heading while doing cataloging. Okay, so assigning subject heading by standard subject heading list or local subject authority list. It may be by a standard. I know I told you about ISO and ISO 39.50, right? It is a common standard. So there are certain standards that provide subject heading list. Okay, or you can create your own subject authority list, or you can create your own controlled vocabulary. Fine, that is also fine. So how to get the subject heading? So where do we get it? So always do not depend upon the title of the book. Okay. So title of the book alone doesn't give you enough details. That means title of the book alone does not give you full details about the thought content of the document, right? Only based on title we cannot say what the book is talking about. Unless if it is simple, it is a simple subject, it is fine. But in case of interdisciplinary or complex subjects, only title cannot give you the full thought content of the document. Okay, so for example, textbook of chemistry, we can say that it is talking about chemistry, or textbook of philosophy, we can say about because it is a simple title, theory of philosophy means it's definitely talking about philosophy. Okay, you see here in the first title, five figures of Nepal. So it may be a biography, political science, or economics. See, figures in the sense you can take it in the point of money also. You can take it in the point of what you call humans also. Five big figures, by political figures or whatever it may be. Or you can take it in the form of a diagram also, or whatever it may be. So since these figures do not have a clear term, clear meaning representation, only after studying the document you will be able to analyze what is the operational definition of figure in this particular book actually. Similarly, for another literature, Seto Bag, it may be a literature, it may fall under the category, this title may fall under the category of literature or about white tiger or what. Unless you study, you cannot understand what the book is talking about, right? So in case of simple titles, we can come to a conclusion that it is definitely talking about a particular subject. But in case of titles like this, which is very vague or having not clearly expressed, it is always better to read the content of the book in order to get a better view of what the book is talking about. So what you should do is you should consult the full title page, verso page, preface, table of contents, indexing, index terms, references, bibliographies, authorship. And after considering all these things, you are not still able to identify the thought content, you should read some pages of the main body of the book. Okay. Even if you are not reading all the pages, at least you should read some of the main pages where you feel you are able to identify what the book is actually talking about. Okay. So now we are actually going to discuss what LCSH is actually, and how they are, what are the principles followed in LCSH. So this is the 33rd edition. This is the 33rd edition of 6 volumes of LCSH. But now we are having, now the present is around 42 or 43rd edition, I think. So let me give you the basics of what LCSH and how they are assigning subject headings. Okay. So this is the introductory part. It is a list of headings. I told you about what is subject headings. It is just a list, nothing but a list to represent the thought content of the document, right? So it is maintained by United States Library of Congress. LCSH is nothing but Library of Congress. You obviously know that. It is used for use in bibliographic records. It is properly known by its abbreviation as LCSH, Library of Congress Subject Headings. It is an alphabetical general list of standard name of subject headings arranged word by word. So its arrangement is word by word, and its order is alphabetical. Okay, it's a sequence of alphabetical. Okay, sometimes it is also called as subject authority file of Library of Congress. So what do you mean by authority file? Authority file is nothing but a list of subject headings. So it is also called as authority file. Now it has about 667,734 records, authority records. So at present, based on 33rd edition, now it might be, the number might be higher actually. Okay. So these are some of the history, the origin of history. So as Ritesh rightly pointed out, it is 1898. So please make a note of the year. So it is 1898 only, that is the correct year. So it is decided to switch on a dictionary catalog based on ALA's list of subject headings for use in its use in dictionary catalog in the year 1898 AD. So then LC started to list preferred terms to be used as subject headings. Okay. So then they started it to list preferred terms that can be used in various subject headings. Okay. These collected list of subject headings was published under the names of subject headings used in the dictionary catalog of the Library of Congress in 1909. So the first publication of the list of subject headings was in the year 1809. The first usage was in the year 1898. So please make a note of it. Okay, and the heading of the document in which the list of subject headings was published was subject headings used in dictionary catalogs of Library of Congress. So that is the first heading, that is the actual heading which was published in 1909. Sometimes they might ask these questions, so please make a note of this title which is given in double quotes. Okay, fine. So this is the history part. So that is purely for to know how the origin of LCSH came into existence actually. So this is purely for your NET examination purposes. So now we are going to, again we are continuing with the history part only. So since 1975 it is renamed as Library of Congress. In 1975 they are renaming LCSH came, the name LCSH came only after 1975. So before that this was the actual name. So make a note of it. They are the American Library Association was a sponsored institute on LCSH, and they formed the Cooperative Subject Cataloging Project. Okay, they published a subject heading manual in 1982. So they are converted into machine readable form in 1986. Machine readable nothing but a computer which can be used or which can be read by a computer. Simple. Okay, in 1986. These are the chronological order for your NET examination purposes. So please kindly make a note of the year and the various names associated with it. Okay, so again this is continuing with the year. The web version, you see, the web version of LCSH started in 2002, and this will be useful for your NET exams. Please make a note. Print version, sometimes the print version they call it as Big Red Book. Print version of LCSH, they call it as Big Red Book. So if you come across this name, please make a note of it. Okay, so this is 33rd edition we are talking about, but at present we are having 43 editions. Okay, fine. Okay, coming to the actual content of what is LCSH, it includes multidisciplinary vocabulary. That means I told you it is not restricted to one subject discipline. It encompasses headings from more than one discipline. So that is called as multidisciplinary. So includes heading in all the subjects from science, religion, social sciences, education, literature, language, philosophy. So it includes, what do you say, heading in all the subjects. Hence it is called as multidisciplinary. So it also includes heading for geographic features, ethnic groups, historical events, building names. You see, it is a model for many other vocabularies in English and other languages that has been translated in numerous languages. That is true. It acts as a common model for many other vocabularies. So it has separate headings for separate terminologies, like to represent geographical features, it has separate heading groups, and it has for ethnic groups, historical events, building names, it has headings. So we will see what they are in the forthcoming slides. Okay, so it is the subject heading, as I told you, it is a subject heading of Library of Congress, that is National Library of Congress, which is located in US. It is being used as the indexing vocabulary in a number of published bibliographies. In terms of published bibliographies, they are using LCSH as an indexing vocabulary. I told you what is a controlled vocabulary. It's nothing but giving a tag to a particular keyword or something in order to make it more identifiable in order to a relevant context, right? So it is useful for big libraries. Okay, LCSH is useful for big libraries like OCLC, okay, and RILN, Research Library Information Network, right? So OCLC is using LCSH based indexing vocabulary. So remember that. So in print, the tools of LCSH in print is free floating subdivisions. Okay, an alphabetical index, it follow alphabetical index. That means it lists all the words that can be used as a subdivision. Okay, subdivision, let it be, I told you, right, physics, force, velocity, like that. Okay, it can be used as a subdivision. So it provides subject cataloging manual in the year 2004. Manual in the sense, what do you mean by manual? A guide how to use these subject headings and what you need to know about these subject headings, like an instruction manual, right? When you purchase a TV, you get a manual, right? So how to on it, how to off it, and what are the buttons, so what are the controls, right? Similarly, the manual provides how to make use of this indexing and subject heading terms. Okay, in terms of online, they have weekly list on changes, new headings, deletions. So online, what they do is they regularly update it. Okay, sometimes a new heading will be added, sometimes a existing heading will be deleted, and there will be changes in certain headings. So it is good idea to assign a staff person to monitor this list too, in order to maintain your catalog regularly. The updation is very much essential. So every week, if you check the LCSH website, they will update the new features. What are the headings have been added, what are the headings have been deleted, and what are the headings have been modified, and so on. So it is always advisable to assign a staff to do this purpose, to check the website in order to update this with your existing catalog, right? See, there are two types of subject headings actually. One is boldface type and one is lightface type. What do you mean by boldface? While typing in Word, we create a control B or something bold, right? It is highlighted. Okay, lightface is not highlighted. It will be in the common. It will be in the common text. So this is light black. This is lightface. This dark black, that is boldface. In common terms, that's what I'm saying. Okay. So that is, they select and use this bold type only. For example, taxation is the heading. So on law and legislation, that is a subtopic for it. So that is bold faced. And what do you say? In the bold face, UF is nothing but used for, or used for, okay? Used for tax law, tax legislation. So these are the, what do you say? These are the lists. These are the lists. This is the subject heading and these are the lists actually, okay? These are the lists where it can be used, in the context where it can be used. It is like tagging. So taxation in the context of law and legislation can be used in tax law, tax legislation, tax regulation, taxation law. So these terminologies, this particular subject heading can be used in various four terminologies. That is the various four terminologies. So that is the meaning of this. Similarly in light phase, you see, the used for, first used for tax law, that is given in the heading, that is given in the heading here, and the main subject, that is given in the bold type. So light face here being light face type is the, here the tax law, that is given in the subject heading, the subject heading, that is given in the light face type, and the original subject, the original subject heading will be given in the bold face type. Okay, the list will be given in the light face type. Okay, so that is the two types. One is bold face, where the actual subject heading is bolded and the list of terms which it can be used for is listed in light face, where the used for terms is listed in light face and the main subject area is listed in bold face. These are the two types of subject headings. So these are the different principles of followed in Library of Congress subject headings. So we will see each and every principle with the example also, so you can easily understand. So remember that Library of Congress subject headings follows six principles. Okay, remember. So no more than three headings per information package. So remember that there should be not more than three headings. Okay, it should be three or less than three. It should not be more than three headings. Let's see that. So if no subject heading exists, create a new subject headings. Okay, in order to maintain your authority file, if there is no subject, Library of Congress subject headings has a predefined vocabulary pertaining to different subjects. We saw that science, social science, arts, etc. Right? If there is no subject headings, please create your own subject heading so that you can maintain your own local authority file. Fine. So the first principle is use warrant. So what do you mean by use warrant? Use warrant is nothing but the words, the heading should be the terms of common usage, right? Where you are using it. In American English, Britain English, it is different, right? British English is different. So for color, American English, they will use C-O-L-O-R, C-O-L-O-U-R in British English, okay? So the thing is, both of them are right actually. Nothing is wrong. And what, where we are using, which is commonly used. In India, which is commonly used? British English. So that means you have to tag it based on color only. C-O-L-O-U-R only. Okay. So which is commonly used, the terms should be used on the basis of use warrant. Use warrant in the sense, in India, British usage is commonly used. So this color, this, the spelling of this color is more preferred. So if you are using this, means that is actually not wrong. But this is in the American context. But in India, if you are indexing for India, Indian documents, that means this terminology should be used in the British context, right? So this is commonly used here. So use warrant, based on use warrant principle, you have to identify which is commonly used in the context where you are going to prepare the subject heading or index, right? So based on that, you have to identify that. Literary warrant, I have already told you, right? It was given by Wijnaldum Hume. It is a concept, nothing but it is concept that whenever there is a heading or something, before, based on the title or some, before, in the names of the classes, okay, the names of the classes or subjects, whatever it may be, just based on the, just based, instead of deriving it based on a certain order, you have to identify what is the existing literature available in it first, okay. For example, if I am saying something about information literacy means, just you cannot write it is from the field of library science. You have to identify where information literacy is first used in the context, right? So you have to get a literature and understand the perspective of the subject, then you assign a class. That is what a literary warrant is saying. Literary is nothing but literature. So, based on the existing literature, what the subject is talking about, so don't preconceive it. That means don't fix it automatically. Don't premeditate it. Okay. So, based on the literature which is available on that particular subject, you frame the class and the subject class of the subject class accordingly. So, that is what the principal is talking about. So, they are created for use in cataloging and reflect the topics covered in a given literature. Okay. So, based on the topic covered in the literature, they are used for cataloging. Okay. The terminology selected to formulate individual subject heading reflect the terminology used in the current literature. Okay. So, based on the current literature, the terminology is selected to formulate individual subject headings. Okay. So, you have to check the literature in what context and what term they have used, and accordingly you have to use it in the formulate the subject headings. So, catalogers examine what is written, the terminology in use, and the context in which the term appears in the literature. Correct. So, you have to read the literature first, and you have to understand, as a cataloger, you have to understand what the terminology in use and which context they appear in the literature. Okay. So, based on the literature, you are deriving indexing terms. Okay. So, this is called as literary warrant. Without preconceiving, you are directly preconceiving, you are reading the literature and identifying what the vocabulary and the terminologies have been used and what context they have been used, and accordingly you are assigning indexing terms. That is principle of literary warrant. So the third principle is uniform heading. You know what is uniform, right? It should be even. Uniform is nothing but even. So one heading is chosen to represent a particular topic. So that must be even. If you are choosing a heading means, so you are a, what do you say, you are a six people, right? So three are male and three are female, right? You are a group of six. So what is the heading for you? We call it as students. So students is a uniform heading for you. Okay, irrespective of what your background is, whatever it may be. So there is a uniform heading. Similarly, when you have a uniform heading, what happens is the materials about a particular topic can be brought together. Okay, materials about a particular topic can be brought together. See, for example, this choral music, guitar music, violin music, all these are different kinds of music. Okay, but the common heading is music only. So, in the music is a uniform title, let it be violin or guitar or piano or whatever it may be, whatever kind it may be, whatever aspect it may be. So, everything related to that particular heading can be brought together. So that is a concept of uniform heading. Okay, fine. The next is unique heading. What do you mean by unique heading? Unique is something different. Okay, standing some, it is not common. Uniform is common, right? Unique is opposite. Something, it should be different. Okay, I have told you this with some other example also, like Python programming, Python snake. Both are having the same meaning. But what is the uniqueness in it? The both are having the same keyword, Python. What is the meaning? Uniqueness in it? The context where it represents, right? Similarly, if a term could represent more than one concept, okay, it should be modified for better understanding. So Venus, it is a planet also. And Venus, you can call it in the Roman deity, okay? In Roman deity, in the, what do you say, in the literature, Greek literature, there is a god called Venus, okay? Similarly, Python, Python programming, Python snake, okay, fine. So, SS is a broader context, and where you are using it, are you referring it for Nepali language or Hindi language or whatever other languages, okay? So, see, you are having one term with more than one concept. So, for that, uniqueness is needed. That is, you are tagging it. You are tagging Roman identity along with Venus. So, this is nothing but a kind of controlled vocabulary. You are controlling the vocabulary where it can be used, okay? I hope now you understand. You are controlling the vocabulary. So Venus in this context is used only to represent Roman deity. So Venus in the first context is used only to represent planet. No other meaning. Simple. Okay. This is called uniqueness. Okay. Fine. So specific entry. So these are the different kinds of entries. So each subject is represented by the most precise term naming the subject rather than the broader or generic term that encompasses it. So precise is accurate. The name specific itself, it need to be so precise and accurate. Okay, it should not be general. Generic is the sense, it's general. Now it should not be general. So for example, music is a general term. When I come to this particular slide, here you can see music is a generic term, general term, and choral music is a specific term because this music represents only the choral part. Okay, or guitar part. So guitar is more specific, whereas music is general. It can represent anything, right? It can represent violin, piano, or whatever it may be. Or a song also, whatever it may be. But when you be more specific, like guitar music or violin or something like that, that means you are being more specific. So each subject, each subject should be represented specifically, right? Example, we will see that. For a work on a school library, you must use school library only. So resources in school library, you have to use school library. School library is specific. But if you use academic library, what will happen? College and university library will also be taken into account. So here they are referring to school library only. So no need to take a college and university library. No need to be more general in this area. So academic library generally consists of three libraries, right? School, college and university. So in the title itself, they have clearly mentioned the content is talking about school library. So you can exclude it. You can clearly be specific about what the content is talking about. So school library would be more appropriate and more precise. Academic library would be more general. Okay, this is a specific entry. So these are some of the examples. For a work on agriculture production, you should use agriculture production, not economics. So sometimes production may be with economics, but here what the title says, production only. So need not to confuse with the general term economics, right? So for a work on low carbohydrate diets, use low carbohydrate diets, not general. When you take carbohydrate means it encompasses high carbohydrates also it will come, low carbohydrates also it will come, general carbohydrates also it will come, right? So they are clearly saying the title is about low carbohydrates. So use that specific term, okay? So not reducing diet, weight loss. If you use low carbohydrate diets, there will be that means you are reducing your diet, and automatically the aim is to reduce your weight. So that is the ultimate aim. The general aim is that. But title, they have clearly mentioned low carbohydrate diets. So no need to use these extra concepts, extra general concepts, okay? In order to add more terms, that is not required actually. Use specific terms. That is what they are saying here. Okay, fine. I hope you understand this particular part. So now consistency. What do you mean by consistency? Consistency is getting the same results without much change in your performance or what change in your attitude, whatever it may be. That means from now you are in the third semester, right? So till three semester, Abhilash is getting around, his average is around 73, 74. That means he is consistently performing. He is not increasing, he has not improved or he has not declined, right? So his performance is consistent, maintaining at the same level. That is called consistency. Maintaining at the same level. He is not changing or he is not moving forward or he is not moving backward. Simple. That is called consistency. So attempts are made to maintain consistency in form and structures among similar subject headings. That is true actually. When you change the subject headings, what will happen is for one heading you will write one title, for same title if you write another heading, means the consistency is not maintained and the users will get confused easily. So consistency should be maintained. So LCSH was developed over the past century. It contains numerous inconsistencies. That means lots of inconsistencies are there. So when headings are changed or new headings are established, every week it is happening, right? So headings and bibliographical records needs to be updated, right? That should be true. When every week when headings are changed or something is deleted from LCSH in the new edition, accordingly you have to update your bibliographical record or else the consistency is not maintained. If you are still keeping the old edition, means that is wrong actually. And the new edition, when the user checks it from that point of view, will not find the exact document, right? So some of the changes that are made continuously to maintain the currency. Currency is, what do you mean by currency? Not money here. Currency is keeping up with the current topic. That is currency. Okay. Currency is not money. Okay. Currency is keeping up with the current topic, that is currency. Okay, some of the examples are people handicapped, people with disability. Some of the examples are, usually in the earlier stage they used, right, people with disabilities. Okay, so now what they did is, some of the recent changes, what they did is they have changed it to handicapped, right? So handicapped has been changed into people with disabilities. Okay, so handicapped in the sense, and handicapped is a specific meaning. Okay, handicapped is a specific meaning, whereas people with disabilities encompasses broader concept, right? That means you can include even physical disability as well as mental disability. Handicapped in the sense, you can say only physical disability. If your arm is amputated, you can say handicapped person. But if he is mentally unstable, you can say people with disabilities or special ability. So people with disability is a broader concept, that is a commonly used phrase now. So via currency and viability is, you have to sustain in the current scenario. That is, currency is update yourself, right? So computer network has been changed to internet, right? Computer network is internet, nothing but a connection of networks, right? Simple. Machine readable dictionaries is electronic. So see the changes they have made. So still, if you are indexing using this term, means people will find it difficult, because they are nowadays people are used to the term electronic, and if you still keep machine readable, so some users might find it difficult. So in order, currency and updation is very much needed. So that is why we call this concept as dynamism. You should be dynamic. Dynamic in the sense, static and dynamic in the sense that static is your, static in the sense you are standing at a single place. Dynamic is you are moving it forward and backward. That means you are ready for change, actually, in the sense, in this context, you are ready for change. You have to be dynamic. You have to be flexible to change. Okay. So that is what they are talking about. Pre-coordination, post-coordination, I think I have already told you. Pre-coordination indexing terms and post-coordination indexing terms, right? So what is this? Chain indexing, precise, POPSI, all are pre-coordination, right? So combining elements into one heading string in anticipation of a search on compound topic. In chain link, what we anticipate is sort headings, right? Sort headings. We anticipate that these headings are likely to be sought. That's why we use the word likely. Likely is in anticipation. So users will look based on this heading only. For a topic on colon classification, people will look only on classification or colon only, not on classification. Classification means it will include DY decimal, universal decimal, Library of Congress and other classifications also. So you think that according to your nature of the library, according to nature of your users in the library, you will think my users will most probably will look for the keyword colon instead of classification, because classification encompasses broader books also, other books also, and when he comes with colon as a short term, so you will get specific results. So you are anticipating guess of a search that on a compound topic. So this is, you are pre-coordinating the terms, what the user is like going, what the user is likely going to refer on that particular term. That is called pre-coordination. Pre is before, post is after, remember that. Okay, so it is LCSH. Remember, LCSH is a pre-coordinate, not a post-coordinate. Okay, so furniture design, France. See how they have coordinated this. So furniture design, that is a topic. France, history, 20th century. They have coordinated according to certain concepts, right? Furniture design might be the thought content of the subject. France is the location. It's talking about furniture design in France or something. So it is represent to history. In the 20th century, furniture design of France, history of furniture design in France in 20th century. If that is a title, they have clearly fixed according to certain order, right? That is means they are pre-coordinating. So people will search based on these four particular terms. These are the sort headings, okay? Or these are the input terms in terms of precis or something, okay? So that is what. So culture, Nepal. So history of culture or something in the culture of Nepal in 18th century. So there are three pre-coordinate terms. So the LCSH is based on pre-coordinate. Post-coordinate is nothing but after. post is similarly post is, so now you are in post net exam era. What do you mean by that? You have completed your net exam, that means you are post. What you have to do post? You have to attend classes and prepare for syllabus for semester exams. So that is your post net exam work, right? Similar. So post is combining the headings of keyword by a user at the time he or she looks for materials. So remember, post coordination is done by the user, not by the library staff. So what he does is he combines, the user combines the keywords while he is searching for the document. Okay. So for a work on library system of Rana period in Nepal, so user will combine like that. Oh, I have to search for library system Rana period Nepal. So he is combining according to his requirement, that is post coordination. Here the same can be pre-coordinated according to your library's cataloging, library's cataloger. What they can do is they will combine that Nepal history, Rana period, library system. They can coordinate according to their terms. Here the user coordinate himself while he is searching for the document. So that is called as pre-post coordinate. Okay. It's done by the user. Remember that pre-coordinate is done by the library staff or cataloger. Okay. So these are the different subject headings. Okay. It appears in many formats, single headings. So surgery, roses, flowers, these come under single headings. And compound phrase, simple and compound phrase like mobile culture, surgical tools, like that. These are compound. It combines more than one phrase. That is compound, right? And then heading with subdivisions to create strings. Alcoholic beverages, subdivisions. Taxation law, Nepal, heading with subdivisions to create strings. So next terms, in input strings we saw in pop quizzes, right? We saw the list of strings, how to create strings in pre-coordinate indexing system, right? So alcoholic beverages, what are the alcoholic beverages available? Taxation law, what it is talking about? The next strings, right? To create next strings. So types of subject headings are, there are three types actually. So topics are identified by the terms or phrases that represent what the materials cover. So you know what is a topic, right? Say a topic is nothing but you read the material and you identify what the material is talking about. So when you identify the key terms or key phrases, that is called as topic. Simple. Okay. So there are three general categories of subject headings, and one is topical, one is form, one is names. Okay. So these are the three. You know what is topic, right? They are the key terms what the book or document is talking about. The simple word, they are simple words or a combination of phrases used to reflect the major subject content of the book. So these topics can be what you call things, philosophies, disciplines, activities. So in case of theory of philosophy, so theory is a topic, philosophy is also a topic. So philosophy, theory is the concept of that particular book, and philosophy falls under the category discipline. Similarly, ethnic groups or culture. Okay, culture. Okay. Ethnic groups, so race, whatever it may be, classes of people, a book on PG students, so classes of people, it depends upon the very, a book on religion. So these categories falls under topic. Okay, organization. Okay, research publication of Central University of Punjab. Okay, research is a topic, publication is a topic, Central University of Punjab, which falls under organization, that is also a topical form of subject heading. Okay, that is a topical form, topical type of subject heading or form. Okay, so second is form. So topic is nothing but representing the terms represent the content of the thought content of the subject or the document. Form, what do you mean by form? So what kind of book it is, what kind of, it does not describe the content. So content is described by the topical form. So form usually represent intellectual or physical form. Physical form means whether it is a book or a journal or something like that, whether it is a dictionary or a reference source or a science fiction or a classic or a novel or whatever it may be. Okay. And the intellectual, it is about drama, it is about art, it is about an essay, whatever it may be. So intellectual and physical features of the book, physical features of the book are known as form subject. So thought content is called as topical subject, physical features and intellectual features are called as form. And name, you all can clearly identify what is a name, right? It is given to different descriptors like geographical names. What do you mean by geography? Geographical locations. Okay, like Nepal. Okay, like Tamil is a place in Nepal. Okay, features that may range from large continent to small city or a small place. Okay, let it be continent is Asia. Okay, Asia, India, world, Asia, India. So these are the geographical names depending upon the context and where it is used. It is note this is possible. It is not possible to cover all geographical names available in the world for any subject heading in a single volume. That is true actually. Okay, there are more than what you say. Let's say there are more than 200 countries in the world. Okay, approximately we'll say. So in 200 countries there will be lots and lots of places. In India, if you take it, how many states are there? In single state, how many districts are there? In districts, how many villages are there? How many semi-urbans are there? It is not possible, right? It is not possible to cover all the places, all the locations. Okay, so the cataloger, you must, according to the situation, the cataloger, if the book is talking about India on a particular village, you have to establish with the help of standard reference sources. Okay, so India, this village falls in India, simple. Okay, based on that, you have to establish a geographical heading with the help of a standard reference source. Fine. So syntax, what do you mean by syntax? Forming word. Generally in syntax and computer words, what we call it, it's a set of rules. Step 1, code this. Step 2, code. Step 2, do this, like this. That is the syntax. It is a process which is done step by step. So here, in direct form, using natural language or qualified form. So LCSH may be used, maybe in direct form, using natural language. Natural language is what we are speaking naturally, or qualified. Certain terms can be used for certain context only. That is qualified. You are qualifying it from natural to, you are upgrading the terms. We will see it. Okay. So direct form is electrical cars. Electrical cars. Electrical cars means you are not talking about electricity. You are talking, you are not talking about electricity alone and cars alone. It is electric cars. Okay, it is not cars or not electrics. So it should be combined. It should be combination of both electric as well as cars. It is not cars alone. It is not electric alone. Okay, political parties. It is not parties alone and it is not political alone. So it should be combination of both the words or both the phrases used. So that is direct form. So whatever it is presented here, you have to use it directly. You cannot separate it. That is direct form. Okay. So when you are representing an object or a concept, CD-ROMs. See, CD-ROMs, they have used a S. S means plural. There is more than one CD. And CD-ROM is singular. There is only one CD. Okay. Heat. Not heat is a singular. Heats, not heats. Okay. Scooters. Scooters, not scooter. Okay. Love, not loves. Love. See, they have used only to particular concept. Here only the singular form. Here only the plural form is used, and you have to use it in the same form only, not in the singular form. Whatever form they have used, you have to use it in the same form. So you are using, this is to represent an object or a concept in direct form, right? So adjective or participle noun equivalence is blind, poor, etc. Okay, fine. You have to use it as it is. So articles, these are some of the, what is a rules. Syntax is nothing but rules. How you have to use syntax, I told you, it is a rules. How you have to use in the natural language, in the direct form and in the qualified form, you have to use it like this. So for CD-ROMs, if you write CD-ROM, it will be wrong. So that you are changing the rule. According to the rules, what they have given, you have to use it as it is to represent an object or concept. Okay. So CD-ROM is an object, whereas heat or love is a concept, right? So what here they have used love, not loves. So you have to use what they have used. Okay. So while using articles, you know that a and the, right? Arts, not the arts. You cannot use in order to create appropriate English syntactical relationship, you cannot add article according to your convenience. Whatever they have given in the rules, you have to follow that. Articles are not in the initial position. Initial in the sense first. Initial means first. You should not put an article first. An apple, a book. You should not write like that. In LCSH, in common literary terms, it is correct. But in LCSH, this is the syntax. This is the rules for articles. Articles should not be in the initial positions. The arts is not right here, okay? Only arts. Education, not the education. So you should not write the education, okay? So you should not give emphasis, importance to articles here. So articles should not be in the first, okay? That is the rule here. Articles may be retained for grammatical purposes. In some case, articles may be retained for grammatical purposes. That means in order to in order to assure that the sentence is grammatically correct, you can retain some articles. Okay, state the, not the state. The state means the coming initial, the coming front. That is wrong. State the concepts. State the concepts or something like that. Whatever it may be. So state is a key index subject heading. The is may be retained for grammatical purpose. But anyway, remember that article should not be in the initial position in LCSS. Remember that. Okay, these are the rules actually. You have to follow the syntaxes or else you will get error. That is wrong actually. Plural, singular, these are grammatical rules. I am talking about grammar rules. Not with English grammar rules. We are discussing in context with Library of Congress subject heading English grammar rules. Okay. So, plural, singular, I already told you. Headings representing objects or classes of people are usually plural. Classes of people, okay, or objects. Usual objects or classes of people. Physicians means there is more than one physician. Okay. Pencils means there is more than one pencils. Representing objects or classes of people. Headings, when you are giving a heading to an object or a class of people, okay, like doctors or whatever it may be, it should be plural only. So that is the rule. Biological species are generally singular, high levels are plural. Biological species are singular, higher levels are plural. So bald eagle, you can say it as eagles. Australian cows, okay. Western lily, lilies. Okay, so biological species, when you are using in the biological concept, you have to use it in singular only, but when you are using in the normal higher level, it should be plural. So these are the rules while using LCSH. For single concepts used when a single noun cannot represent an object or concept. Okay, so it is used when a single noun cannot represent an object or concept. That means a single noun, a single word of noun cannot represent a full concept. So you can use like this classical rhythm, a library ethics. Ethics in the sense is ethics is a single noun only. But what happens is when you keep ethics, you cannot say it is talking about library ethics or it is talking about research ethics or it is talking about other ethical values or something. So when you are using you can use phrased headings. You can use these phrased headings when you feel that this single ethics alone cannot represent the context of where it is used. That means you are adding library as a phrase to ethics. Okay. So it may be prepositional phrases also, figures of speech, quality of life, adult children of alcoholics. So these are called prepositional phrases. Okay. So these are nothing but grammatical rules used in LCSH. So these are authorized headings, components of entries. These are the different components of entries. So authorized headings, class numbers. So about 36% of the headings have LCSH class number. So not our DDC. They are Library of Congress classification number. Not our class, not DDC or UDC. They will have class numbers. That only 36% of the headings have Library of Congress class numbers. References, they are used for BT refers to broader term. NT refers to narrower term, RT is related terms, SA is C also. So these are the general references they have used in terms of entries, right? See, authorized headings, letters, not subdued George. So that is the keyword they have given, and these are the class numbers for this. These are the class numbers for history and criticism in Library of Congress classification scheme. And UF is used for, letters are used for correspondence. Correspondence is communication. Where will you use letter for correspondence only? So BT is broader term. It is a biographical source, right? I am writing a letter about myself. I am writing a letter about my problems. I am sharing it with you. It is a biographical source. Or it may be literature. RT, related terms is letter writing. The related terms, see how they are giving. This is the context, okay? This is the context and this is how they are giving. This is authorized heading. So here letter is the authorized heading, okay? So for this, they are having some class numbers. Letters falls under the main class of history and criticism and the subclass of collections. So this is the main subject heading, okay? So usually subject headings have Library of Congress classification number, and the UF used for correspondence, that is communication. So letter falls under biographical sources, that is broader term we can say biographical source, biography, letters of biography or literature. Related terms, related, what we use related to letter writing, okay? So C also, references, for headings for letter qualified by language. I am writing a letter in Tamil or Malayalam or Hindi, whatever it may be, Latin letters, American letters. See, remember that in Library of Congress subject headings, authorized heading. What do you mean by authorized heading? This is the authorized heading. It should be listed in bold face, bold. See, the letter is in bold font, right? So it should be listed in bold face type. See, these are the formats and syntax. So other relationships based on other references. Equivalences, equivalence, where it is used and used for. Hierarchical, top to bottom, broader and narrower term, broader, hierarchical, top to bottom, right? Associative, related terms. So general references, these references are classified into different relationships. Remember that. Equivalence, hierarchical, associative and general. Associative means grouping. Related terms is grouping together. Hierarchical in the sense, how will you say, it's a top to bottom structure, right? Broader term, narrower term. Used for equivalence, where it will be used. So general is C also. Remember this. This is very important, okay? So this is a scope note. So scope note provides guidance for the application of the heading, okay? Scope note provides guidance, okay? For the same authoritative concept, the scope authoritative heading. So letter writing is a scope note, okay? Letter writing is a scope note and it follows the etiquette. It comes under etiquette, English rhetoric. The sub-collection is English rhetoric. These are the classification number. Here are the entered general works on English letter writing. So used for correspondence, English letter writing, English writing of letters. So it provides further guidance where the scope of this heading can be used further. Simple, okay. This, for that particular authority, we have this is a particular example of how to provide LCSH heading. In the authorized heading, this is the authorized heading, and this will be the related, this will be the scope note where it can be applied further. Scope of usage. Okay. So these are the different reference relationships, right? Equivalence, associative, hierarchical and general relationships and the classification numbers, main classes, that is ERT. They won't call it as main class, they will call it as heading, okay? They will call it as subject heading, not classes, okay? And the subject heading will have class number. This is a perfect example for this. This is the type of relationships of different references, and this is the scope note for that particular authoritative heading letter. And now we are coming to the subdivision part, the final part. So there are different kinds of subdivisions. You know what is a subdivision, right? There will be a main heading, there will be a subheading. Simple. Okay. To express a specific aspect of a subject, to bring out the specific objects. So narrow down the scope. You are narrowing down from physics to quantum mechanics or force or velocity. So physics is the broader main division, and velocity or force is the subdivision. So topical subdivision, I told you about topic, right? It represents the thought content of the document in keywords or in terms of terms or subject headings. Okay, topical. So helicopters is the main division, and flight testing and everything comes under flight testing. So library science is the main division, or law librarian will be the subdivision or something like that. Okay, or laws of library science or something like that. Form, I told you. It can be intellectual or physical form, right? So engineering, it deals about not the subject. It is not dealing about whether mechanical or civil. If it says about mechanical or civil, it will be topical. It says about what kind of document it is. It is a periodical. Let it be a journal or let it be a magazine, whatever it may be. It is a periodical. So English, it says about what form of document. It is a dictionary. Okay, it is not a book. It is a dictionary. So the form, geographical, the location. Okay, statistics of Nepal. Library education in Nepal, okay, where something is located, where the document is located or where it is from, or depending upon the topic. Chronological is year-wise subdivision, right? So referred to as time period or year-wise, whatever it may be. Printing of history in 19th century, Nepal history in 1951, etc. So there are four types of subdivisions. Topical, not tropical, it's topical, or remember, remove this R, okay? Topical, geographical, chronological. Form, topical, form, geographical, chronological, okay? So they are having separate subdivision. In the print version we saw about free floating, right? It is called the common subdivision, okay? It more specific or more it is called the common it helps a heading to be more specific, actually, okay? So list of subdivisions that are authorized for free floating in the Library of Congress system are authorized subdivision, I have told you, it will be in the boldface, like letters, okay? Like following a long dash, like anatomy, civilization, statistics, okay? So author subdivision will be like this, boldfaced. So free floating is, it began to create authority records from 1999. Free floating, topical, form, again four types are there. Free floating is, it will be more specific actually. You can float it according to your convenience actually. The full set of has been published in January 2018 and it includes one geographic subdivision also. It is published by the Catalog Distribution Service of the Library of Congress and it is revised annually. So kindly check this for further information. So these are the references and the bibliography used to prepare this particular presentation. So kindly go through this for additional information and also go through this catalog. This particular website where they give tutorial about what is LCSH with step by step. You can always go through this particular website to gain more knowledge on the topic. So thank you.